Shiva is more fundamental than Krishna. Shiva is more fundamental than Krishna. Krishna contains a lot of both Shiva and Shakti. So unless you are watchful, you will get confused. Shiva is simple and pure. Shiva has the benefit of just being Shiva, with Shakti expressed totally as a different entity, which though emanating from Shiva, yet is very different from Shiva. In Krishna, you find Shiva and Shakti both, and you do not know which is which. Do not know what is what.
So Shakti is more the material world.
Yes. Shiva is pure stillness. In Krishna, you see both stillness and dance. Hinduism is only as complex as life. And if you need to have something to guide you through life, it will need to be at least on the same level as life, if not a higher level. Do not ask why Hinduism is complicated. Ask why have our minds been dumbed down to look at only at oversimplified versions of reality. Somebody might be living only in black, white and grey, and then you come to see that the human eye is capable of looking at 30 more colors. Would you call that complexity or richness? I'm asking you again. You are living in black, white and grey, and here you come to see that there are 30 more colors. Not only 30 more colors, 30 more mutually interacting colors. Now do you call that complexity or richness? Do you dismiss it or do you play those colors on the day of Holi? Yeah? What kind of Holi would that be? Only black, white and grey. Complexity is in the human mind. One starts with complexity because it is a fact. We live in complexity. But the goal of religion is to bring you to simplicity. Religion does not take you to complexity. Complexity already is. It is our own lives that are already complex. So religion begins from there and then takes you to utter simplicity, in which there is not much, just silence.
Silence is not necessarily opposite
to richness. No, not at all. In the middle of all richness, there is silence. In the middle of all of this, there is silence. There is no opposition.
Speaking of God, sir.
In fact, if there is silence, then you will call diversity as richness. And if there is no silence, then you will call diversity as a problem. Diversity can be called both a problem or fun. Ah, so much! Or, oh, so much! It depends on how much power you have. Stand at the right place, have good power, then all diversity is just fun, richness. Diversity means differences. Differences are always there. Every moment is new. It is different compared to the previous one.